Her name is etched into Australian history, and Lindy Chamberlain Creighton is our special guest today. Just about all Australians know your name. Or have you found that to be a hindrance?
I've gradually got used to it. So some of my friends say now, oh, when you're not looking, you just go by with your nose in the air. And I said to her, do I really?
And why not?
And she's like, yeah, you have the thousand-yard stare. And I suppose she developed that because so many people were saying things and doing rude things and you ignore it. And I think it's become a habit, which
everyone,
is not good.
Everyone had an opinion about your case, about you and Azaria, and what happened at Ayers Rock that fateful day. But I, you know, when I interviewed you in Darwin, Darwin Jail in Berrima,
about a lifetime
33
ago.
Years ago, or whatever it was, we were trying to remember. But you know, after we published the story in the Sun newspaper in Sydney, which no longer exists, your mother wrote to me.
Did she?
And she said, and I've always remembered it, if only people had seen the depth of your despair as you cried every night, they would understand your grief. And she said, and I've always remembered this too, no one should criticise another until they've walked 2 weeks in their moccasins.
As long as they've got the same corns.
but that always was the problem. Everyone had a view. I don't think you're ever given a fair go.
Well, that's human nature though, isn't it? We tend to get just a teeny bit of information and then jump to a conclusion. So we should all be fit. Unfortunately, we're not.
but how, though, did you manage? Because you sit here now just glowing and looking gorgeous with your glittery, sparkly nails, which I
think
are fantastic. How did you endure that terrible time and still come through with such grace and dignity?
Well, first of all, I have this favourite saying. It's a bit like eating an elephant. If somebody gives you the elephant right in front of you and says, now you ought to eat that, you just get, you're kidding, and you don't even start. But if you're given it one mouthful at a time, so you can't see how much is coming, you know, one meal at a time, you get through it. And it's the same with this, you know, you just have to take it second by second, you know, and I just say to myself, God, help me through this second. Because and then the next second, and then that was the only way I could do it. And knowing I was innocent and knowing God knew I was innocent, the rest didn't matter.
So your faith was really important to you. I mean, it's pulled you through, hasn't it, through the dark days?
I always thought if something happened to one of my kids, it'd be, you know, that's the end of God. And I just knew in that split second, I can't do it any other way. It's the only thing I've got.
So do you, you wish God might have allowed the Australian people to know you a little bit better then and perhaps even now?
I don't actually waste my time on looking back and wishing. You know what they say about wishing? Spit in one hand, wish in the other and you'll have more spit. So it's like...
Although you say you don't like looking back, is there anything that you think you would have liked to have either handled differently or done differently over those years?
Not with the information that I had at the time. I think the only thing that's good to look back on is the happy times. Because that way you're remembering the good things, the joy, the precious memories, and there's enough misery today without having yesterday's, because you can't do anything about that.
Well, I think most people listening to this and looking at you today would think, how did she ever get over it? How did she ever get to be where you are now, sitting here having a little chat and a giggle with us? You now spend a lot of time talking about forgiveness, don't you? But how do you forgive what happened to you?
Well, I learned through this. There's a text in the Bible that says you should forgive 70 times 7. And so on, and I used to think, you know, you're just waiting till the end of that. And then I realised, no, it's got nothing to do with the other guy. And I think churches are wrong teaching that, you know, you should forgive because this is a Christian thing to do. It's got nothing to do with other people. They're responsible for their own nastiness and for the things they do wrong. You're responsible for you. where forgiveness comes in, you've got to forgive yourself for getting sidetracked with all that and believing that that's true instead of what you know is true. And so you forgive yourself for getting sidetracked, and then you go on and you hand the responsibility for all the rest of that rubbish back to the person that did it, and so they're carrying the burden, not you. And then if they realise they've done the wrong thing and they want to straighten their own life out and they come to you and say, I'm sorry, it's not a problem because you've already dealt with it. You're not carrying their burden, and you can say, fine, you're forgiven because I moved on a long time ago. And that's where we're wrong in saying, I have to forgive you for what you did wrong. It's not my responsibility to tell you that you were wrong or say I'm better than you because I've forgiven you, which makes me a better person. It's not about that. We have forgiveness backwards, and when we put it the right way, you know, you go back and visit the nasty things that are done to you and then you've got to go, stop it. You know, start again, think about where you are, and you never get over it, and you're not saying what other people did was all right by doing this. You're saying, I'm not going to take your blame and I'm going to be happy with what I've done. And you know, 90%... the experts, and their drips under pressure, but anyway, they say that 90% of how you feel every day is how you personally decide to feel when you get up in the morning.
Well, you're feeling pretty good now, aren't you? Because you've just become a grandmother, you're moving up to Queensland, you're here with your second husband now, you're making a new life, and it's looking pretty good.
Yeah, well, having fun.
Thank you for sharing your story with us today.
Thank you.
We really appreciate it. Lindy Chamberlain, and we're going to have more of Studio 10 right after this break.